I'm Shawn Wright, owner of Brigade Wakesurfing here in Boise, Idaho. We build custom wake surf boards from scratch, just like the true ocean boards. You hand shape them with EPS foam, fiberglass, the whole thing. Brigade Wakesurfing started with a dream. Someone came to me, his name's Nick Scott, and he really came to me with this whole idea and this dream that he has that wakesurfing is going to be the next big sport. I didn't know anything about it. He came to me and was like, hey, I got this idea. He was really into the competition side of things. He was known for doing the best and first 720 in competition. And so he was really into it. His heart was there, and he came to me basically pitching me this idea of Brigade and building our own boards and really making boards built for surfing behind the boat. No one was really doing that yet. It was still really new. No one even knew about it. And he pitched that idea to me and said, hey, I want to try this. I want to see if we can do it. And I had no idea. I hadn't even surfed before. And he said, let me take you out. Let me show you what it's all about. He sold me on it. I mean, immediately I was all about it and wanted to be a part of this. We cleared out my garage. Every car I had was parked in the driveway, and we built a room specifically for shaping, painted the walls blue, and just visqueen plasticed every little spot we could to try and do each process of the board. And we started building some boards, and we learn by trial and error, for sure. I mean, we're here in Boise, Idaho. There is no surfing here for a long, long ways, and no one building boards. But we did, as we started getting into it ourselves, we learned that Soulcraft was a big wake surfing brand at the time, and they were getting involved as well. And Jeff lived here in Boise, and we found out about him, went and met him, learned some tricks, and he showed us what he was doing and got us even more excited. Great, we got some help here, we're gonna learn. And he ended up leaving. He had to go to California, and we're kind of like, me and Nick are looking at each other, just shoot, what are we gonna do now? Jeff was gonna teach us how to do this, and now he's gone, and what are we gonna do? So I said, we're gonna do this, Nick. We're gonna learn how to do this ourselves. That's the best way to do it. My dad always told me that if you want something to happen, do it yourself. So we struggled through it. I don't know how many boards we ruined. I mean, the first board he finally got finished and shaped out, he said, Shawn, you're gonna paint these, right? And I'm like, I had no creativity at all. I've never even painted a stick figure that good. And he's like, well, someone's gotta do it. I had to learn how to shape. You gotta learn how to paint. So he gave me the first board, and what did I do? Take a rattle can right to the foam and melted it clear through. The first board he shaped, destroyed, ruined. And I'm looking at him like, well, now we know not to do that. And that is what's brought in Brigade to where we're at now, is don't know how to do it, let's figure it out. It's not something, we don't know how to do it, let's ask someone, let's do this. We'll find a way to make it happen. And Brigade's got us to that point. And the bad thing is about it, we got to a stage to where we were growing super fast, and money was an issue. We're two 27, 28 year old kids at the time, and money was tough. And just like any business that you start, you're working your real job at the same time to try and get your goal and your dream to get to that point. And so Nick was building pools, and I was doing electrical work, and we were working at night till 3 a.m. at times, all in our garage. And that's something that everyone thinks is really cool. We started in a garage, just like those big companies, and it was fun. It got to the point though that where boards were spilling out of every bedroom I had, and I was sleeping on traction, and it got to where it was pretty crazy, and we're getting a lot of orders, and Nick was in the shaping bay way too long and glassing way too many boards all on his own, and I think that's what happened, is he got sick of it, got tired of it, where he started seeing the numbers and the money going in and out, and it, I don't know if it scared him, but he decided to do his own thing and leave Brigade and left me in a tough situation. Now I'm back to square one, like when we met Soulcraft, and I don't have a guy building boards, I don't have a guy shaping, and And I really wasn't doing much except be in the bank and painting a board here and there when we were doing custom stuff. And so Brigade kind of had a new phase, and we started a new crew, and I met some new kids here in town that I helped teach, and they gave me their aspects of what they were doing. I met a kid named Jordan, who's now my glass guy. He was building airplanes here in town, and so he had a lot of creativity with doing carbon fiber stuff, because all their planes are out of carbon fiber. And he struggled with it just like me and Nick did at the start, but the more we learn and the more we do it, the better they're getting. And that's something I'm proud of. The boards from the first one to the ones we have now are awesome. Really cool. I like what we have. We designed it so that when people come in, they can see each process of the board building, and it's all glassed in so people can watch from the outside of the room and not have to put the masks on or put Visqueen on to go into the rooms. They can actually watch from the outside like a field trip. Kids can come on a field trip and check out the board building process. So it also helps for customers when they want to come in and order a board. They can see each stage, especially local people. That's my favorite thing. They get the VIP Brigade treatment, and they get to see the start. And most people are like, whoa, they're made of foam? They had no idea. They think they're made of bamboo or whatever they look like on the outside. And they get to see that process, and we let them shape it and help them do certain things. And when it gets to the cool part of graphics and art, they get to be a part of all that. And now that we have this facility and this shop that I'm more comfortable with letting people into, it got kind of weird when strangers were rolling in my garage designing their board. So now I'm proud that, yeah, come to the shop, come on in, I'll show you what we're doing. And be a part of it, and especially in Boise. I mean, no one knows this stuff, no one's seen this stuff, so it's so new to them. Their eyes light up. It really keeps me going. It's those things that when I'm here till 3 a.m. painting a board, those people coming in every other week with their eyes wide open and getting to hold their board and seeing their art they designed on a napkin that we ended up putting on a board, that's really, really cool for me. It keeps me going. Our specialty is definitely I call it the cool factor. A lot of the brands out there just slap their name on it and say, hey, this is our boards, buy them. Our thing is custom. We want you to be riding the board designed by you, built by true wake surfers. And that's really gotten us where we're at. You call us up and you want a picture of your family on the bottom of the board, we're gonna do that. If we don't know how, we're gonna find a way to make it happen. So I'm really proud of that. I'm happy that we kind of have our niche in a niche market of wake surfing, building custom boards, and being in Boise, Idaho, it's pretty awesome to drive a truck around with surfboards on the side of your truck and people are wondering what you're doing here. So I'm stoked on what we're doing, and can't wait to see what's coming. We got some big things coming up for 2015, and even beyond that, we have some ideas even further ahead that we're working on, and can't wait to unveil that to you guys, and keep stoking out on us.